Can you describe how it feels to now officially be a BAFTA award winner?
It feels good. You know, I don't know. It's very absurd. It feels good, though.
Does it feel a little bit strange when you're up against your co-star with Savannah?
Yeah, I know. That's really weird. But obviously, you know, she, if it wasn't for her performance, like, I don't think I'd have been able to bring out everything that I did. So big shout out to Savannah again. It's just a nice way for kids to learn about, you know, sex education and, you know, what's okay, what's not. And, like, it's okay for a guy not necessarily to know everything, you know what I mean? Character's only Ryan's 17 and, you know, he's trying to pretend. But, you know, it's relatable.
And in terms of filming some of those scenes, can you talk a little bit about how difficult it is not only to be doing something that's already a little bit awkward, but to be doing it in front of cameras and with Savannah in front of you?
To be honest, like, she was really good. Adam was really good. Toby, our cinematographer, he was really... It was a real nice environment. So it was like, after the first few awkward, funny times, it's just like, we just got into it, sort of. So, yeah.
And why do you think it is so important to have children's programming that does explore complex and sometimes adult themes?
I just think it's something that everyone needs to know. You know, it's like, everyone kind of shields you from it, but it's like, you might as well just let them know earlier, sort of. It just helps, I think, get rid of a lot of misconceptions.
In terms of the future, what's coming up for you in 2018?
2018, well, this independent film by Make Light company called 2 Hours is coming out, hopefully maybe the end of this year, next year. And I have a little small bit in Slaughterhouse Rules, which is produced by Simon Pegg, which is going to be released next year.
What does it mean for you and the entire TrueTube family to have won here tonight the Children's BAFTAs?
Well, we're a very small TrueTube family, so it is it's completely overwhelming, and we are over the moon, just so pleased. And I was completely tongue-tied on stage accepting it because it was completely unexpected. I just didn't think we would win. Well, hardly anyone's heard of TrueTube, which is what's so surprising. But we are our prime mission is to make short films for teachers to use in schools to discuss moral, social, ethical, religious issues with the kids. And it's kind of values education, really. It's trying to get kids to talk about the things that matter. So it's kind of the soft skills, the stuff that they might not be learning in maths or in science and so on. So we are primarily an education site, so that we're used in lessons, we're used in RE, PSHE, citizenship and assemblies, that kind of thing.
And I guess my final question, can you talk about the unique challenges and rewards of crafting programming for children that specifically deals with such complex and sometimes adult themes?
We try to find the... This sounds a bit pretentious, but we're trying to find the humanity of the issue. So, for instance, we want to make a film about refugees, or we want to make a film about the differences between Shia Islam and Sunni Islam. We kind of try and find characters to express their views as people, rather than as kind of, as a monolith, or rather than, you know, talking heads. So the characters who talk to each other and interact with each other tell a story that hopefully kids will be engaged by.
Oh, it's wonderful for Screwball, it's wonderful for TrueTube. I am so thrilled that the BAFTA jury chose to reward a piece of work that seeks to help young people deal with some of the most challenging, potentially awkward situations, conversations that they'll find themselves in growing up, to do with sex, to do with relationships, consent. They're not easy issues. Approaching them with comedy for us was obviously a brave decision, I couldn't be happier that it's paid off, and I really just hope that it helps the film, which is free and available on TrueTube, to reach students, teachers and parents all over the country. I think that you know, the tools we have as storytellers with film, the rhythm we can give to something, I guess the energy, the colour can, and in Screwball's case, hopefully the humour can be invaluable to helping make issues that might feel, as I say, awkward or quite dry, suddenly feel accessible. All our films are short as well, sort of always less than 15 minutes, close to 10. So, I'm a believer in the form, absolutely. So I hope that humour is a refreshing approach for an audience who I know will be used to issues like consent being approached very seriously in a lot of cases. I think that what I wanted to do with the film was show a couple of young people going through an encounter that I think a lot of young people relate to, where they don't know what they're doing, and find the humour in that. And I think humour makes it okay to have a conversation in a way that it doesn't necessarily feel okay if everything feels quite consequence heavy and serious. So honestly, once we made that decision, it wasn't hugely difficult to find the humour in the situation, because in many ways, sex and relationships can be very absurd things, and so we just tease that out, I guess.
This film looks at online social media in a very kind of evocative way, I would say, and to use a platform that's based on social media as well, based online, to discuss issues about social media seems like a great way to engage young people. I think that we need to kind of raise more awareness of the issues online, and using a platform like TrueTube to do that is fantastic.
It's just amazing, so incredible. I'm so grateful to be part of such an outstanding team, and for these guys, it was just such a privilege. And watching them, I was so proud. And then walking up myself, I was like, oh my God, it's so surreal. But just incredible.
Can you talk a little bit about why it was important for you to be part of a project like this that tackles these themes and aimed at an audience that probably isn't too different in age from you yourself?
Yeah, well, obviously, it's about warning young children and teenagers about social media, and being one myself was really awakening, actually, and eye-opening to what it can actually be, and obviously so relatable. So it was just really touching and close to my heart, because I've grown up with social media, as most people my age have, and doing something that's going to open kids' eyes at my age was just so raw and real. So it was just amazing, yeah.
Curious, I mean, this, you describe it as a cautionary tale. Has it changed the way you interact with social media? Because I think obviously for a lot of people, they treat social media as something that's quite impermanent. And I think we're starting to realise that actually what we do online has long-term and sometimes even permanent consequences.
Yeah, do you know what? It definitely opened my eyes, and it has actually definitely changed things for me, because every time I start getting too addicted to my phone, I think, remember the movie. So it actually has changed things massively, and just opened my eyes to think, actually, and playing that character myself made me think, actually, that could be me. And so, yeah, definitely very eye-opening.
With every individual film, it's about the subject matter, I'm, again, really thrilled that the BAFTA jury have chosen to recognize that the emotional experience of social media is a stressful one for teenagers. It's one that we, as a kind of creative industry, as storytellers, have only just, I think, begun to wrap our head around, our film included. You know, the treatment that I wrote for this could have taken in a huge number of other areas and topics, and we had to kind of settle with just picking a very thin slice of it. So it's a massive, massive challenge, I think, for young people, for society, but hopefully the film will make a little bit of a positive impact in that ongoing discussion and conversation that I'm sure will end well. I do think the internet is a positive force for society on net, and I just hope that this film helps us get to that point.
It's a real validation of the work we're trying to do, which is to sort of get young people to think about values, to think about empathy, to think about understanding other people, to think about their lives more deeply. It's very overwhelming as well to be, we're a tiny outfit with a tiny budget, and we have won in four categories, and it's astonishing. Yeah.